This is Dr. D. Govardhan, Professor in Ed, Department of Aeronautical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today, the topic deals with the introduction of engineering mechanics and its classifications, laws of mechanics, and resultant of forces by using graphical method. The engineering mechanics is a branch of applied mechanics which deals with the laws and the principles of mechanics along with their applications to the engineering problems. Hence, the engineering mechanics is very essential for engineering in the areas of planning, designing, and construction of various types of structures and machines. The engineering mechanics deals with the forces acting on a body when it is rest or in motion. The engineering mechanics based on status of the body as well as the forces are acting on it. It is classified as mainly two groups, statics and dynamics. Statics is defined as the part of the engineering mechanics which deals with the forces acting on it when the body is at rest. The dynamics is the part of engineering mechanics which deals with the forces acting on a body when it is in motion. The dynamics again further classified into kinematics and kinetics. The kinematics deals with the motion of the body without considering the forces which are acting on it. The example, V is equal to U plus AT, that is initial velocity and final velocity and acceleration that are involving in this equation, but we are not at all considering the forces which causes the motion of the body. Similarly, one more equation is there, S is equal to UT plus 1 by 2 AT square and V square minus U square equal to 2AS. In all these three equations, which deals with the initial velocity, final velocity, time taken and accelerations without considering the forces which are acting on it. And kinetics is a part of the dynamics which deals with the motion of the body as well as the forces acting on it. The fundamental laws of mechanics are mainly six types: Newton first law, Newton second law, Newton third law, Newton's law of gravitation, law of transmissibility of forces, and parallelogram of forces, law of triangle of forces, and law of polygon of forces. The Newton first law states that the body is at rest or moving at a constant speed in a straight line. It will remain at rest or keeping in a straight line at constant speed unless it is acted upon by an external force. The example is, the body in motion would remain in motion unless a force causes it to come to rest. The best example is, when the body is moving, when it is coming to the rest without application of any force means due to experience of frictional force between the moving body as well as the surface of the earth. This Newton's law, the Newton's first law, yes, it gives the definition of force or inertia. The second law of Newton's states that the rate of change of momentum of a body is equal in both magnitude and direction of the applied force on it. The moment of a body is equal to the product of its mass, its velocity. That is, the rate of change of momentum means the difference of final velocity and initial velocity divided by time, it is equal to the force now. Or in other words, F is equal to mv minus mu divided by t, or m, just if you take common word, that is F is equal to mv minus mu divided by t, R which is also equal to M V minus U divided by T, or we can take it as MA now. So, it is a quantitative description of the changes that force can produce on the motion of the body. Now, Newton's third law, it said that when the two bodies interact, they apply forces to one another that are equal in magnitude and in opposite directions. Or in other words, this law deals with the action as well as the reaction forces acting on a body. This is an important law for analyzing the problems where the forces are balanced. For example, a book is there, or just small object is there, which is kept over the table. Its weight is acting downward directions, but it is not at all falling downward directions because the table surface also imposes a force on the body to keep it in balanced positions. The force exerted by the book or the body on the surface of the table, it is treated as action force. That is, the weight is not treated as action force. The force exerted by the surface on the body to keep it in balanced position is treated as a reaction force. Or if you take the objects, the weight is acting downward directions, but reaction force is acting upward directions. Both are equal in magnitude and acting in opposite directions. This is an important formula for analyzing the forces by removing the supports what it is having and keeping equivalent reactions on it. Fourth law, Newton's law of gravitation. Every body attracts other body. The force of attraction between two bodies is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Let M1 and M2 are representing masses of the two bodies, 1 and 2, which are separated by a distance d. Then according to the Newton's law of gravitation, the force of attraction between these two bodies is given by g into M1, M2 divided by d square, or the product of two masses are proportional to the product of two masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, where g is fifth law of transmissibility of forces. It says that the state of the body rest or in motion is unaltered. If a force acting on a body is replaced by another force of the same magnitude and direction, but acting anywhere of the body along the line of action of the replaced force. Fifth, law of transmissibility of forces. The state of rest or motion of a body is unaltered If the force acting on the body is replaced by another force of the same magnitude and direction along the line of action of the force at any point. Example, the first figure, it states that here the body is there, the force is acting at a point A. This is treated as a line of action of the force. If you change the point of application of force at other point B, having the same magnitude and direction, the effect of the force on the body is unaltered. Similarly, the second figure also given. Here, the force is changing from A to B position now. Here it is a point A is there. The line of action, the effect of this force on the body is unaltered. Similarly, on the surface of the circular part, three forces are acting. If the line of action of the forces, the point of application of the force, if it is changed from A, B, C to O, that is to intersect at one point, the effect of this forces, it will not be unaltered, even though the point of application changes from A, B, C to O point. The law of transmissibility of forces, the state of rest of the state of rest or motion of a rigid body is unaltered if a force acting on a body is replaced by another force of the same magnitude and direction, but acting anywhere on the body along the line of action of the replaced force. Here, the example is there. A rectangular body. The force is acting at a point A. Now it is treated as a line of action now. If the application of the point of application of force, if it changes from A to B, the effect of this force on the body, it will not be unaltered. Okay, these are the three examples we have taken now. The second figure also there, and the third one also. It deals with the application of the force from one point to another point, that it changes, but its effect is unaltered. This is also one of the important problems for analysis of forces which are acting on a structure. Parallelogram of forces. This law is most important for determining resultant of two forces acting on a body by using graphical method. It states that if two forces are acting simultaneously on a body at a point, are represented by both in magnitude and direction of two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, then the resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal passing through the point of intersection of the two sides which are representing the applied forces. That means here it is a one force is there already, assume this is a P force and it is a Q force, both are acting at a point O now. These two forces are represented as adjacent sides of a parallelogram, both in magnitude and direction. That means, draw the parallelogram now. Then, the resultant of these two forces is the diagonal passing through this intersection where these two forces are acting, both in magnitude and directions. Sixth, parallelogram of forces. If two forces are acting simultaneously on a body at a point, are represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, then their resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram which passes through the point of intersection of the two sides representing the forces. Here P is representing one force and Q is representing another force. Both are acting at a point O. These two forces are represented as adjacent sides of a parallelogram, both in magnitude and direction. It is a parallelogram now. Then, the diagonal which is passing through point O is representing magnitude and direction of the resultant of these two forces. Triangular forces. Triangular forces, it is the modification of parallelogram of forces. It is also used for finding resultant of two forces are acting in a body in both magnitude and direction graphically. It states that if two forces are acting simultaneously on a particle, be represented in magnitude and direction by the two sides of a triangle taken in order. Their resultant may be represented in magnitude and direction by the third side of the triangle taken in opposite order. Here, the force P and Q, these both are acting at a point O. These two forces are represented as sides of a triangle taken in order. That means here O, P is one force. This is another force Q now. Q taken in order means tail, head and tail head. These two forces are representing both in magnitude and direction but taken in order. The third side or closing side of this is representing resultant of these two forces but taken in opposite order. That means O, A is one order, tail and head. A and B there for the second force is the order now. Then BO is representing resultant of these two forces but taken in opposite order. Triangular forces. Triangular forces, it is an important law for determining resultant of two forces acting in a body in both magnitude and directions. It states that if two forces are acting simultaneously on a particle, be represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of a triangle taken in order. The closing side is representing the resultant of these two forces both in magnitude and direction but in opposite order. That means if P is the one force is acting now and Q is the one more force is acting at a point O on a particle, these two forces are representing two adjacent sides of a triangle both in magnitude and direction. Then the closing side is representing resultant of these two forces but taken in opposite order. So O, P and Q are the two forces. Taken in order means tail, head, tail and head. The closing side is representing R but it has taken in opposite order. Now polygon law of forces. This is also important for the determination of resultant of several forces are acting on a body. It states that when the number of forces are acting on a body simultaneously be represented in magnitude and direction by the sides of a polygon taken in order, then the closing side of the polygon is representing the resultant of these two forces law of polygon of forces. It is also important law for determining resultant of several forces acting on a body both in magnitude and directions. It states that if number of forces are acting simultaneously on a particle be represented in magnitude and direction by the sides of a polygon taken in order, then the resultant of all the forces may be represented in magnitude and direction by the closing sides of the polygon taken in opposite order. Now here polygon means it consists of more than three sides. If n number of forces that are acting means this n number of forces representing the sides of a polygon taken in order. Order means tail and head, tail and head. The closing side, that is n plus 1 side, it is representing resultant of this n forces but taken in opposite order. Here examples, the forces A, B, C, D, E are acting at the point O of a particle. These forces are represented by the sides of a polygon taken in order. Here O, A is representing, that is A force. Similarly B force, example the forces A, B, C, D, E are acting at a point O on a body. These forces are represented as the sides of a polygon like OA, AB. It is in the order is required and like this. Example, the forces, the forces A, B, C, D, E are acting at a point O on a particle. These are represented as sides of a polygon both in magnitude and direction as OA, AB, BC, CD, DE, taken in order. That means tail and head, tail and head, tail and head. The closing side EO is representing resultant of these five forces but taken in opposite order. That is, it should be in opposite order is required. This is also one of the important important principle for finding resultant of several forces acting on a body by using graphical method. Now, particle. Here I am taking example is body having the weight of nearly assume 10 kgs. But if I divide it into two parts equally, that is each part is again having 5 kgs and 5 kgs and so on. If I divide into four equal parts, each is having 2.5 kgs, 2.5 kgs and so on. But when I am taking this as a total 10 kgs body, and here example I am taking particle. Here particle, for defining this particle, let us first consider the body having 10 kgs. When it is divided into four equal parts, each part is having 2.5 kgs, 2.5 kgs and so on. So the resultant of these four pieces, that is 2.5 kgs, is equal to 10 kgs and so on. But these parallel forces, 2.5 kgs, 2.5 kgs, the resultant is equal to 10 kgs, but it is passing through a single point. That point is called a center of gravity. That means that entire weight of the object is concentrated at one point, that is at center of gravity, and the remaining part, it is assumed to be not having any weight now. Or in other words, the particle is treated as it is infinitely small volume, but the weight is concentrated at that point. Okay, particle. Particle may be defined as a body of infinitesimally small volume, but its weight is considered to be concentrated at one point. Example, I am taking a body of 10 kgs. If it is divided into four equal parts, each part is having 2.5 kgs and so on, the weight is acting perpendicular to the surface of the ground. The resultant of these four parallel forces is equal to 10 kgs. But generally, it passes through a single point. It is called center of gravity. That means the weight of the body is concentrated at one point. For an analysis point of view, we are considering the volume of the body is negligible. Okay, this is called a particle. Particle may be defined as a body of infinitesimally small volume and its weight is concentrated at one point. Rigid body. Rigid body. It is a difficult exists a rigid body in universe. When the forces are acting on a body, it always undergoes some deformations. The deformations may be varying from 1 metal to another metal. But the deformation is taking place because of forces are acting on it. But for theoretical point of view, we are considering rigid body is a body which will not go any deformations, that is changing in dimensions, when it is subjected to forces. It is difficult to exist in the universe. All the bodies rigid body. A rigid body may be defined as a body which can retain its shape, size when it is subjected to some external forces. It is difficult to exist a rigid body in the universe because every materials undergoes deformations when it is subjected to external forces. The deformations quantity, it may be varying. But for simplicity purpose, for analysis of forces, generally the deformation is for analysis point of view, the deformation which is produced is negligible when comparing with the dimension of the body. Hence, the type of bodies are treated as rigid bodies. Rigid body. A rigid body may be defined as a body which retain its shape, size, even if subjected to some external forces. It is difficult to exist a rigid body in the universe because every material undergoes deformations when the forces are acting on it. But some materials, the deformation is negligible when comparing with the dimensions of the object. Hence, that type of bodies here treated as rigid bodies for the analysis of forces which are acting on it. Effect of force. The force is a vector quantity. That means it is represented both in magnitude and directions. Effect of a force. When the force is acting on a body, it may change the motion of the body. When the body is at rest or when it is in motion, effects of a force. A force may produce the following effects on a body on which it acts. It may change the motion of a body. That is, if the body is at rest, the force may set in motion. And if the body is already in motion, the force may accelerate it. The second point, it may retard the motion of the body. The best example is when the body is moving because of action of braking force or the friction force which exists between the contact surfaces, just it retards its motions. It may give rise the internal stresses in the body on which it acts. The characteristics of force. The force is a vector quantity. It is represented both in magnitude and directions. Example, magnitude of force is equal to 100 newtons or 50 newtons, 20 newtons or 5 kilonewtons and so on. And the directions, because it is a vector quantity. The direction of the line along which the force acts is known as the line of action of the force. These two are treated as here vector quantity. That means it is representing both in magnitude and directions. But another important characteristic is nature of the force. That means what is the effect of that force? It may be pull or push. The example is door is there now. For opening the door, just you can apply the forces. It may be pull or push. Depending on type of the forces, it will open the directions. And shear force, bending force, tensile force, and compressive forces. That is, depending on type of the forces, the effect on the body also changes. Shearing force means just it cut the body. Bending force means it bends the body in concave or convex directions. Compressive forces, because of action of the forces, the dimension of the body decreases in the line of action of the force. Tensile force, that elongation of the body is produced in the direction of the applied force. And fourth one, the point at which the force acts on a body. That is the point of application of the force. Where it acts in? That is, the characteristics of the forces are four types. One is the magnitude, second one is the direction, third one is the nature of the force, and the fourth one is the point of application of the force. Okay, thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.